I've been teaching for 4 years. All 4 years I've been teaching here since I graduated from UConn. My teaching style, I always like to describe as somewhere between a Bill Nye episode and the movie School of Rock. My dream is to have like a maker space where the kids just have the tools that they are really accustomed to using. They have the skills we practiced in the beginning of the year to use them. And then I give them the problem to solve or the lab to investigate, and they just go and do it. I think a lot of times kids get affirmed and recognized for doing what they're supposed to be doing, and they need that validation. But it's very, very hard as an adult to watch a kid struggle. But that's where a lot of the learning takes place, is when they're struggling. It's when I see that in the classroom, when they struggle and they're a little bit upset, that's when they're learning. And I think that they oftentimes get sheltered from that because everything is so quick and easy to find answers to now. But it's not always so quick and easy, and I try to make it so it's not. And I try to make it so there's not always one right answer. The program, especially at TCPCG, was really, really tight-knit. And so the students there were family. I still talk to a lot of them. I work with a lot of them here. When I found out that I was getting hired here and I found out that some other people from my program, from my year, were coming to the school, I was ecstatic. I have always told people that you're gonna have a lot of pressures based on your pace of your curriculum and assessments and teacher evaluations. But ultimately, to me, what I found is most important and really what pans out to be most successful with the kids is being responsive to the kids. You know, if you have an assignment and a kid's not understanding it, or most of the class isn't understanding a part of it, don't move on, don't leave people behind. Regardless of the pace of the curriculum, you've got to be responsive to the kids, because ultimately you can't have them missing out on skills that they're going to need later, either in your class, another class, or later in life as they move on. The kids come in and they feel better about themselves when they leave my class than they did when they came in. So that might not be an academic thing. It might be a personal thing. You know, it might be something that we've talked about that has nothing to do with the project. But as long as they feel better about themselves, whether it was that class period or at the end of the week or a month, or sometimes, and I don't even know, but I'll have a kid come in at the end of the year and say, hey, remember that time we talked? Well, I was going through a really rough time and you cheered me up, or you said something that I thought about and it was important. And I might not realize it, but I hope that that's happening all the time. And so that's really my philosophy now, is if you can make people feel better about themselves based on their learning, then I've done my job.